Yes, good morning dear students. Once again I welcome back all of you to the online class session. Right, so in the previous class we have started our new chapter, which was motion in a plane. And in the previous class we got to know many points regarding the this chapter. Right, we have studied what is meant by motion, and what is a plane, and what are the differences between scalars and vectors. And also we have studied one kind of vectors, right, that was the equal vectors. So up to this much we have completed, right? So equal vectors means what? See, the name itself indicates that the two vectors will be equal. Equal in what? Equal in magnitude and as well as in its direction. So if they are equal in magnitude and direction, those vectors we call it as the equal vectors, right? They have the equal or they have same magnitude and direction, right? And also I have given one example to this, which was example of the car and example of the two boys running on the same path, right? So the next vector is negative vector. Next one is what? Negative vector. See, the negative vector is the two vectors of equal magnitude but opposite in direction, right? What is negative vector? Two vectors of equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So those are kinds of vectors we call it as the negative vector, right? So two vectors of equal in magnitude but opposite in direction right? So once again here we have to take the two vectors, right? And the two vectors should be same in magnitude. Magnitude means, again I am telling you, magnitude is nothing but it's a value, specific value, right? For example, consider a one vector, and this is vector A, right? This is the vector A. And another vector I will take that should be in same, sorry, that should be in magnitude should be same as compared to this one, right? So again I am taking the another vector which has the same magnitude as compared to this one, but this is opposite in direction to this vector. I have taken vector A and this, consider this is the vector B. See, the magnitude is same, the same length we are having here. So this direction is towards this side, and come to this vector, this direction is towards this side. So the definition also says that only two vectors, right, here we are having two vectors equal in magnitude, yes, these are having equal magnitudes, but opposite in direction. See, the direction of this vector is in this direction, and the direction of this vector is in this direction. So these kind of vectors we call it as the negative vectors, right? So another example, again I am taking the same example of car. See here, we are having the car C1, right? So this is moving in this direction, this is moving in this direction with a velocity of 50 meter per second. Assume that here we are having the car C1 which is moving 50 meter per second, right? Another car, I will take a C2 in this direction. So it moves opposite to this car, and it also having the same magnitude, that is 50 meter per second. See, the magnitude is same, 50 meter 50 meter, and both are taking the same time. This car is taking the same time to cover the some distance, and this car is also taking the same time to cover the same distance, but they are in opposite direction. So this is the example for the negative vector, right? So next one is the we have the unit vector, which is third one. Unit vector. See, what was the first one? First one was the equal vector. Second one is the negative vector. Third one is the unit vector. See, unit vector is the vector having unit magnitude, right? What is unit vector? The vector having the unit magnitude. It means the value should be 1, right? I'll write here the vector having unit magnitude. The vector having unit magnitude. So this we will study in next class in detail, right? So the vector having unit magnitude is called unit vector, and which is represented by the n cap. See, this is what cap. Usually we can write in this format. For writing the unit vector, we have to write in this format, that is letter, above that letter we have to write a one cap. So this is called unit vector. And to find the unit vector, we have the one formula. Suppose we are having the vector A, right? So you have to write vector A divided by magnitude of that vector, right? Here which vector we have taken? Vector A. So if you want to write in the magnitude format, so in the last class I have said that just you have to take the modulus like this. What is unit vector? The vector having unit magnitude. The value should be 1. And to find the unit vector, we use this formula. N cap is equals to, this is what cap? N cap is equals to vector A divided by magnitude of vector A. Right. So this is the formula to find the unit vector. Right. So next one is the orthogonal unit vector. Fourth one. Orthogonal unit vector. See, orthogonal unit vector. So before going to that one, first of all, we are studying motion in a plane, right? So plane means what? It is about the two dimension. Plane is what? Two dimensional or two axis, right? So one is x axis, another one is y axis. See here. So if we are write the so if you want to write the unit vector along x axis, that should be I cap. Cap means what? Unit vector. In x axis we have to take I. Similarly, for in y axis we have to take j cap. It means I is the unit vector along x axis, j is the unit vector along y axis. So this is about the two dimensional. Similarly, we can take the three dimensional also like this. So this is the z axis, and in this case we have to take k cap. It means here I, j and k, sorry, I cap, J cap, and K cap are the unit vectors along x axis, y axis, and z axis. Right. So here we have the orthogonal unit vector. See, orthogonal unit vector is nothing but the unit vectors along x axis, y axis, and z axis are perpendicular to each other. See here, a three dimensional is nothing but this is the one axis, this is the y axis, and that another axis should be like this, but we cannot show like this, right? Yes, now you can see clearly. See, this is the three dimensional x axis, y axis, and z axis. We can show by the chalk piece like this. So this is what y axis, that is the one axis, and this is the x axis, another z axis will be like this. So this is how we can represent in space, but on the board or on the plane we are writing or we are drawing like this to understand purpose. See here, orthogonal unit vector. See, in a rectangular coordinate system, this is what rectangular coordinate system, in which in x-axis the unit vector I is present, and in y-axis the unit vector j is present, and in z-axis the unit vector k is present. It means in coordinate system all the three unit vectors, that is I, j, k, are perpendicular to each other. ಹೌದ್ರಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಐ ಏನದ ಈ ತರ ಅದ ಐ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಜೆ ಐ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಜೆ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಜೆ ಈಸ್ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟು ಐ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ 90 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಮಾಡಿಫೈ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ J, sorry, it becomes I, and this becomes J, right? It means I is perpendicular to I is perpendicular to J, and J is perpendicular to I. And in similar way, K is also perpendicular to I, and K is also perpendicular to J. The meaning is that all the three unit vectors are perpendicular to each other. So that kind of vectors we call it as the orthogonal unit vectors, right? I'll write here, in a rectangular coordinate system, in a rectangular coordinate system, the unit vectors, the unit vectors I cap, comma j cap, comma k cap, these three are perpendicular to each other. So this is what we call orthogonal unit vector. You just remember that orthogonal unit vector is nothing but, first we will consider one rectangular coordinate system in which three axes are present, x, y, and z. In x axis I vector, in y axis j vector, in z axis k vector. All these three are perpendicular to each other. So those kind of vectors we call it as the orthogonal unit vector, right? So write these two definition, we will come back. Next one, we are having the collinear vectors. Yes, sorry, this is the fifth one, collinear vectors. See, first one is what is collinear vectors. See, the two vectors having equal or unequal magnitude, right? Two vectors having equal or unequal magnitude but having same direction, right? So what is the condition for collinear vectors? Two vectors having equal, or that may not be having unequal magnitude, but direction should be same. So those kind of vectors we call it as the collinear vectors, right? Two vectors having equal or unequal, two vectors having equal or unequal in magnitude, but having same direction, having same direction. What is collinear vectors? The two vectors having equal or unequal in magnitude, but having same direction, right? For example, consider a one vector. This is the vector A, right? So another vector I will take, that is B vector. See, as you can see here, the magnitude is not same, right? As you can see here, this is having a some magnitude and this is having some another magnitude. It means magnitude is nothing but it is a value. And suppose you assume that this is the length of the vector. It is having this much and this is having this much. It means both are unequal, but the direction is same. The direction is in this way and the direction of B vector is also in this way. So this is the first case, right? Collinear vectors can be magnitude equally driven and unequally driven, but direction should be same, right? So another condition, what he has given, that may be a equal also. So another example, again you take the same vector A having this much of length. I will take another vector B, this is also having same magnitude. So these kind of vectors also we can say collinear vectors. Okay, it doesn't matter that the magnitude should be same or not same, but the direction should be same. This is the condition for the collinear vectors, right? Or another example I will give. So here a boy is there, boy B1, he is running in this direction, right? He is moving in this direction and he is maintaining a speed of 5 meter per second, right? He is maintaining a speed of 5 meter per second. Another boy B2 is there, right? He is maintaining a speed of 3 meter per second. See, the magnitude is not same. Here 5 is there, here 3 is there. But you can see the direction is same of two boys. Boy B1 and boy B2 are running in the same direction, but having the unequal magnitude. And another condition that is the boy B1 maintaining a speed of 5 meter per second and boy B2 also maintain same speed, that is 5 meter per second. So this is also correct. He is saying that the magnitude may be equal or unequal, but the direction should be same. So if the boy B2 running in this direction with the same magnitude, so at that time, can we say that this is the collinear vectors? Is it possible? No, because these two are in opposite direction. He is moving or he is running in this direction and he is running in this direction. So at that time, we cannot say that this is the collinear vector. Keep in your mind, collinear vector means the direction should be same, but the magnitude may vary, right? So next one is we are having the null vector. See, the name itself indicates that null. Null means what? Null is nothing but it is a zero. Right. What is a null? Null means it is a zero. Here we are having null vector. Vectors means magnitude and direction. The vector which is having zero magnitude. Right. The vectors which is having magnitude of zero. Those vectors we call it as the null vectors. Right. I will write here. Vectors having zero magnitude. Vectors having zero magnitude. So those vector we call it as the null vector. For example, one best example I can give. So here one rope is there. Rope andre enri hagga. Right, here we are having one rope. So at this point one person is there P1 and this point another person is there P2. Right, we have taken one rope. Right. Yes, consider this is the one rope, small rope. At this point one person is standing and another point another person is standing. Right. So this person, what he does, he will pull the in this direction, right? So this person pull the in this direction, right? So for so to make the this rope towards in this direction, what he has to do? He has to apply some force. Force is what? Vector quantity. It is having both magnitude and direction, right? So person P1 en martanri ee hagganna ee kade elittanu in this direction. Person P2 en martana avanu en martana ee direction dag en martana aa rope anna elittanu. So rope elibekadre en beku? He has to apply some force. Force is what? Vector quantity. So assume that he apply the person P1 apply the 5 newton of force. Right, person P1 en martanri 5 newton force apply maadi tan kade jokkotan. Right, same force 5 newton, same force person P2 en martana apply martana avun kade jokkotan ee tara. Right, the person P1 is applying the force, right, of 5 newton in this direction and person P2 is applying the same amount of force opposite to the this direction, right? It means it is a plus 5 newton, it is minus 5 newton because they are in opposite direction. So plus 5 minus 5 will get cancelled. So the total magnitude is what? Zero. So if the magnitude is zero, those vectors we call it as the null vectors, right? Remember that null vectors are nothing but vectors having zero magnitude. It means zero value. So this is the example for the null vector, right? So take down this definition. Yes, sir. Seventh one we are having here, coplanar vectors, right? So what is mean by coplanar vectors? See, the vectors which are lying in the same plane, right? The vectors which are lying in the same plane. Now the question is again, what is mean by plane? Plane is nothing but two dimensional or two axis, right? Suppose this is what? This is the one plane. This is the x axis. This is the y axis. So this is one xy plane. This is what? One xy plane. In that plane, the vectors are lying in this plane, same plane. See here. Suppose consider a one vector is lying in this plane and another vector is also lies on the same plane. It means coplanar. It means two vectors or more than two vectors are present or lying in the same plane. So those vectors we call it as the coplanar vectors, right? Suppose one vector lie on this this plane and another vector will lie on the this plane, that is xz plane, then we cannot say that coplanar vectors, right? The vectors should lie in the same plane. Either they should lie in the xy plane or zx plane or xz plane. So those type of vectors we call it as the coplanar vectors, right? I will write the definition. The vectors are lying in the same plane. The vectors are lying in the same plane. So those kind of vectors we call it as the coplanar vectors, right? So next one is the polar vectors. Next one we are having polar vectors, right? So polar vectors is nothing but the vector whose direction is along the motion of the object, right? What is polar vector? The vector whose direction is along the direction of motion of the object. So those kind of vectors we call it as the polar vectors, right? The vector whose direction, the vector whose direction is along the motion of the object, right? For example, consider a car. It is moving in the south, north or any direction. Assume that this is moving in north or south direction, right? In this direction it is moving. Car is what? Car is the object which is moving in this direction, right? So here what he says, polar vector is nothing but the vector whose direction is along the motion of the object. So the motion of the object is in this direction, right? So while moving car, it will have the velocity. Velocity is what? It's a vector. If the car is moving in this direction, and what about the direction of velocity? It also moves in the same direction of the object. If it is moving in northward direction, the velocity or the vector should be moves in the same direction. So that is what we call polar vector. You just keep in your mind in three vector direction mattu object direction same irtam. Car ee direction da move aditandra vector direction nu ade idrolage irtam, ade direction dage irtam. So aa vectors ge naave enantu kiritevi, polar vectors, the vectors whose direction is along the motion of the object, right? So that is polar vectors. So next one is the, and can you give the example for this polar vectors? Example for polar vectors are velocity, right? Acceleration, right? So there is a, these are the example for polar vectors. So next one we have the axial vectors. See, axial vectors is nothing but the vectors whose direction is along the axis of the rotation. What is axial vectors? The vectors whose direction is along its axis. We can also say that along its axis. So can you give the example for axial vectors? Angular velocity, angular momentum. So these are the axial vectors, right? What is axial vectors? The vectors whose direction is along its axis, right? For example, if it is moving in x axis, then the vector should be in its axis only, that is in x axis only. So that is what we called axial vectors, right? So this is about the kinds of vectors, and one more or two vectors are there. So in the next class we will discuss that one, right? Thank you.